It was their third meeting in 3 months. Vladimir Putin and Recep Tayyip Erdogan stressed how strong their relationship has become. The Turkish president traveled to Moscow with a large business delegation, but there was one deal that dominated the meeting: Turkey's controversial purchase of Russia's S-400 state-of-the-art missile defense system. Just a week ago, US Vice President Mike Pence warned that Turkey could lose its NATO membership if it goes ahead with the deal. Meanwhile, in return, the US has suspended Turkey's purchase of F-35 fighter jets. The US has been fiercely against the deal because it says the S-400 system, which is one of the world's most powerful air defense systems, could be a threat. Erdogan reassured the Russians there's no need to worry.
We have already created the S-400 roadmap. The necessary steps are done. Everything is finished. If, after that, someone comes up with recommendations to abandon it and won't recognize our opinion, if we have already signed an agreement, of course we will continue to move forward. This is our sovereign right.
Both leaders spoke at length about Syria and announced a new approach to control violence in Idlib, blamed on armed groups like Hayat Tahrir al-Sham. Russia recently complained that Turkey had failed to live up to its promise that it would control rebel groups in the province, as agreed in Sochi last year.
We are in principle getting a joint patrol to have a patrol from two sides. We haven't managed to create a monitoring center yet, but I'm sure we will do it. Yes, the movement in this direction isn't going as fast as we'd wished, but there is movement, and as I said before in my statement, all the terrorist centers must be liquidated, and that's what we're aiming for.
Putin and Erdogan have found an ally in each other in their determination to stand up to the United States. But on other major issues, like the long-term solution for Syria, there are still some significant differences. Step Vaessen, Al Jazeera, Moscow.